Hello friends, how are you? Are you enjoying the videos? So many videos I have uploaded on your Moodle. Friends, whatever I am saying, you take it very seriously. We all are going through very crucial situation. If we want to come out of this situation, the only solution is be at home. So be at home, it doesn't mean that you sit idle. See, this is the technology we have at the tip of our finger, and using this technology we resume our regular work, regular duties, and we work as if nothing odd is happening in our life. We are ignoring the situation and we are doing our work. That is the that's what we have to show to this situation. And we have to come out of this situation. Only teachers are providing you online resources. So you go through all these resources. If you have any difficulty, any doubt, I have provided you discussion forum. You post your doubt in the discussion forum, or you can contact me personally. Don't hesitate to contact. And the discussion forum is the online platform for peer learning. So we all the 70 students and the teacher together, we participate in the discussion and we together discuss all the concepts that are given in all these videos. So these videos are as good as your lectures, because your examination may be in the month of May as per our regular schedule, and it will not be postponed. Okay. So come to our video. In the last video, we have discussed extrinsic semiconductor, and at the end of the video, I have posed one question, but nobody has answered this question. So, okay, so we come to the question. My question was, what is the position of Fermi level in extrinsic semiconductor? Now, you know what is Fermi level? See, in intrinsic semiconductor, number of electrons in conduction band is equal to number of holes in valence band, and hence the Fermi level, that is center of gravity, it is at the center of energy gap. But this is not the situation in extrinsic semiconductor. For example, if we take n-type, the number of electrons in conduction band is greater than number of holes in valence band. So this is the greater number. So where would be the Fermi level, or where would be the center of gravity? Yes, correct. It will not be at the center, but it will be above the center, or we can say it is near the conduction band. Similarly, in p-type semiconductor, number of holes in valence band is greater than number of electrons in conduction band. So this number is greater. So again, the Fermi level, that is center of gravity, it will not be at the center, but it is below the center, or we can say it is near the valence band. So we consider n-type semiconductor. See, this is the n-type semiconductor. In the last video, we have discussed it. There is donor impurity, that is phosphorus. And this donor impurity or phosphorus, it is ionized, means it loses the electron, and that electron is given to conduction band. So that donor atom, that phosphorus atom, it has a separate energy level, and that separate energy level, at this level, it is donor, ED. It means it is donor energy level. Now in the last video, we have seen what is the energy required to lose the electron for phosphorus. It is 0.01 electron volt. So this is 0.01. Okay. So when one donor atom or one phosphorus atom is ionized, one electron is given to conduction band, and this is the Fermi level. You see, this is the Fermi level in n-type. So can we say it is between the donor level and conduction band? Okay. This Fermi level in n-type, it is between donor level and conduction band. But what is the exact position? So we will derive the equation for that. So before going to the derivation, So let us talk about what is probability. Okay, what is the concept of probability? I will give you one example. Suppose you arrange one program, music program. So capacity of your hall is suppose 100. It means there are 100 chairs and the 50 persons attended your program. So what is the probability that each chair occupied? Yes, correct. It is 50% or it is 0.5. Suppose only 25 persons were present for your program, then what is the probability? It means 25 chairs occupied and 75 chairs unoccupied. So what is the probability that chair is occupied? Yes, correct. It is 0.25, correct. Okay, or it is 25%. So how do you find it? Yes, we have very simple formula. So probability that chair is occupied is number of persons upon number of chairs. Correct. In the first case, it is 50 upon 100 and the second 25 upon 100. Correct. So from this formula, we see what is the number of persons present for the program. So it is number of chairs into probability. Got it? Similarly, what is the number of electrons present in conduction band? Because we are considering n-type, so we consider conduction band. So instead of number of persons, we consider number of electrons in conduction band. So equation is number of chairs, it means number of energy levels in conduction band, into probability that chair occupied. So here probability that the energy level occupied. Got it? Number of persons means you consider number of electrons. Number of chairs, it means you consider number of energy levels, and into probability. Now we know the probability equation f of ec. Ec means conduction band. So f of ec, that is the probability that conduction band energy occupied, is 1 upon 1 plus exponential ec minus ef by kt. This is the standard formula, Fermi-Dirac distribution. We have seen it in one of the video. Now see, this ec minus ef, okay, it is about 0.5 to 0.6 electron volt. And we know at room temperature, kt is only 0.26. Kt is 0.26, while this ec minus ef, can we say it is much more than kt? So this exponential term, see, this ec minus ef upon kt is much greater than 1. So this exponential term is much greater than 1. So this one we neglect. So if we neglect this one, what we get? 1 upon exponential ec minus ef by kt. So does it mean it is exponential minus ec minus ef by kt? Or we can say it is exponential ef minus ec upon kt. Okay. So now we write the formula for density of conduction electron. Density means just per unit volume, or we can say it is just number of electrons. So as per our formula, what is the number of electrons? It is nc. It is number of energy levels into probability. So this is the standard equation for number of energy levels. It is 2 into 2 pi m star kt upon h square raised to 3 by 2. This is the standard formula for energy levels in conduction band. See, this m star, it is the effective mass of electron. Now we know mass of electron, 9.1 into 10 raised to minus 31 kg. We use this value in all our calculations. But friends, you remember, when we consider the electron in the energy band in solid, its mass is not 9.1 into 10 raised to minus 31. It behaves with separate value, and that value is called as effective mass of electron. It is the mass of electron in energy band structure, and we call it as m star. So this is the formula for energy bands, number of energy bands. And this is the probability, exponential EF minus EC by KT. Just we have seen it, how this equation is reduced. So this is our equation 1. Okay, so friends, we stop here. So we have come to the equation for number of electrons in conduction band. So we stop here. The next derivation, we will see it in the next lecture. Okay, thank you. Thank you very much.